At 6 tonight, a lot of people are wondering how long coronavirus can live in the air and also on surfaces like packages and takeout boxes for food. So we wanted to find out. My co-anchor Todd Quinones is working from home. And Todd, you spoke to the ICU medical director at Southern Hills Hospital today. So do we need to be wiping things down like packages and our to-go orders?
Yes, bottom line, in order to be safe, because what we do know now is that COVID-19 can live on surfaces and also in the air for hours. So to be safe, it certainly would be a good idea to wipe down those packages. But it does also have something to do with something called the viral load, which is another way of saying the amount of the virus that we're exposed to. It is that part of the equation that can really determine how sick we get, if we get sick at all.
Probably the best number out there is probably going to be when the virus is aerosolized, because at that point in time, it'll last for, you know, several hours or so. But again, that's going to be contingent upon what environment are they in, a warm environment, a cold environment, a dry environment. So there's even variables there.
We've heard about this from the very beginning, about how long the virus can survive on packages and surfaces. Do we have a better understanding of that time frame?
Some individuals might have seen publication data that the virus could last, you know, up to 3 days on a hard surface. But they have to remember that that's in a laboratory condition where we're controlling for humidity and for temperature, and there's no such thing as friction on those surfaces, et cetera. And that's not a really replica of real life.
Not all COVID-19 positive people are equal.
I happen to be a positive individual and I sneeze. Say perhaps I might maybe release 100 viral particles into the air. And if you had maybe a scarf or a surgical mask or an N95 mask, you would have the ability to filter out a certain portion of that 100 viral particles. But if I happen to be an individual who is very symptomatic at the current time, excreting high amounts of virus, say when I sneeze, I might excrete 1,000 particles into the air. Then depending on the type of filtering device that someone uses, it's still beneficial. It'll filter out some type of viral load, but you're still at risk of exposure in that instance to a higher amount of viral load.
And so it is depending on how much of the virus that we are exposed to in conjunction with our own immune system's ability to fight off the virus. That is sort of the formula that will determine exactly how sick we may get, if we get sick at all. But Dr. Vasopoulos right now telling us, Tricia, indicating at least that it appears this virus may not live as long in the real world as it does in the laboratory. So there is some good news there.
Yeah, so interesting. So much more information we're going to learn as the days continue to go. Todd, thank you so much.